listening to an audio article by the Common Constitutionalist. Today's article is entitled, Justice is Not Blind, It Sees Only What It Wants to See. We've all heard the saying that justice is blind, thus the statue of Justitia, or Lady Justice, blindfolded and holding the scale of equal justice under the law. As nice a sentiment and goal that is, it is not reality. Rather, it is said that there are two systems of justice, those for the haves and those for the have-nots. But even that's not accurate, at least not anymore. Now we have three systems, or tiers, of justice. One for the have-nots, one for the haves, and one reserved only for a politically well-connected inner circle. The have-nots are the regular folks, like you and me. If we ever find ourselves on the wrong side of the law, regardless of the circumstance, we can expect zero perks and zero favors done on our behalf. We can expect the full measure of justice handed down as punishment for our transgressions, owing only to the compassion and mercy of a jury and or judge. Our only hope is that the judge and or jury may find some sympathy for and pity on us, thus lessening our punishment slightly. The haves are the next up in our three-tiered justice system. They are the wealthy, the Hollywood elite or Wall Street magnates, and the like. They are indeed rich and powerful and have a lot of influence, but only in their fields. When these people find themselves at odds with Johnny Law, they are able to hire some of the best defense attorneys money can buy, which may mitigate their punishment somewhat. But the efforts of their high-priced attorneys still may not be enough to expunge all the charges leveled against them. They may end up with a decreased sentence, a portion considered time served, community service instead of prison time, or massive fines in lieu of prison time. But being rich and famous can also be a double-edged sword. You may be rich and infamous, like, say, Bernie Madoff, or Jeffrey Skilling and Bernie Ebers, both of the hated company Enron. These guys had the proverbial book thrown at them, partly because they were in fact found guilty, but also to make an example of them. But these guys are the exceptions to the rule. Most lower-profile cases involving the wealthy are given special treatment that can be purchased for the right price. And now we come to the final of our three-tiered justice system. This tier is most prevalent on the federal level, and all involve not the rich and famous, but the politically connected. These individuals are the worst of the worst, who use and abuse their position or political clout for personal or professional gain, and most don't seem to care whose lives they ruin or who they must sell out in the process. We've heard the chants of lock her up ringing through stadiums around the country, but still, no one has been locked up. Not a her or a him. Not anyone. Not Clinton or Brennan or Clapper or Rice or Comey, etc., etc., etc. And all we can say is that these third-tier people never get what they deserve. No matter how egregious, they get away with everything. It's not fair. Justice is not served. However, things began to look up when the Washington Examiner reported on July 28 that, quote, a top Republican investigator said accountability is coming for any of those individuals who may have committed crimes during the Trump-Russia investigation, unquote. Well, yay, it's about time. Now it may only be a question of who goes down first. But that elation was short-lived, as just 3 days later, on July 31, that same Washington Examiner reported that, quote, the Justice Department declined to prosecute former FBI Director James Comey following a criminal referral from the agent's independent watchdog, Michael Horowitz, which concluded that Comey had leaked classified information and showed a lack of candor with investigators, unquote. It was clear as a bell that Comey broke the law, but will evidently skate through like so many other politically connected criminals, past and present. With these types of results, and I expect no different outcome from any of the other Democrat crooks and liars, it's not hard to understand why we on the right are so jaded when it comes to the federal government. No matter what we do or who we elect, the swamp lives on, seemingly impervious to anyone or anything. And they who dwell within feel that they can get away with practically anything and pay little to no penalty. And why wouldn't they feel this way? They do. Thank you for listening.